forced to use paper maps because .NET MAUI didn't have a Windows implementation of the maps control. That changes now with the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, which provides a Windows maps implementation, and this is not even a map. There is a little bit of a backstory to the maps control, right? For Xamarin Forms, way back when, you had a maps control which was implemented on iOS, Android, and Windows, because that's how it works, right? For Xamarin Forms, and now for .NET MAUI, everything gets mapped to however it should look and feel and work on that platform. So for iOS, you would get Apple Maps, for Android, you would get Google Maps, and for Windows, you would get Bing Maps. That's how it works. But for .NET MAUI, we've swapped out UWP as a Windows backend for WinUI. And for UWP, there was the maps control, but for WinUI, there is no maps control. So this is kind of a problem, right? Like, the .NET MAUI team is not really in the business of creating their own controls and maintaining those. We just map all the things to whatever should work on the platform, right? So ideally, the WinUI team should implement a maps control, and then we can finish the work there. But the ask for a maps control on iOS and Android was so big and so loud that we had to make the choice to implement it for iOS and Android, make that available, and not have anything for Windows. Until today. We have the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, where we can implement something that is not as official, but we can still help you out, right, as the community. So what we did is add the Windows Maps control in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, and it basically is a web view that loads Bing Maps with the API key, but it still has all the stuff. It works with the same API as the actual Maps control for iOS and Android, so you can still add your pins, add your things, add your polylines, all that kind of stuff, and that will still work with the same API. You just need to install an extra package. Is it ideal? Maybe not, but this will help you out with implementing maps also on Windows. So let's go check out how to get started. As with most of my videos, I created a little sample project to show you how to get started. So here in Visual Studio 2022, I created this project. You can find the code in the GitHub link that is linked in the video description below. I do that for all my videos, so you can find it there. And I've already installed the NuGet package, but an update has been released minutes ago. It's almost like I have released that package myself. And so let's update the package. It's the exact same if you want to install it for the first time. Even if you've been working with .NET MAUI Maps before, you need to install this package onto your project to make it also work for Windows. So let's go over to your project, right-click, do Manage NuGet Packages. And here we're going to, well, I have it under Updates here, the CommunityToolkit.Maui.Maps. You should be looking for it under the Browse tab and search for CommunityToolkit.Maui.Maps, right? So you can find it, not a comma, dot maps. So you can find it here. At the time of recording, just released hot of the press, 1.0.2. So install that version. For me, it's going to say update, but you can install that version. And whenever you do, I think the readme.txt comes up with a couple of instructions, as we do with the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. And the important part is here, you want to use the use Community Toolkit maps, and then you have to specify the Bing API key. So let's just copy this one, and I'm going to close this readme.txt and also the NuGet packages screen here. And I'm going to go to my solution explorer and click on the mauiprogram.cs. And here in the builder, you probably, if you're using maps already, you have like .usemauimaps. If you're not using it yet, it will be installed as part of this package as well, because it has a dependency on each other, right? So you should have this one in here. And you can also now add this use Maui Community Toolkit maps, and you need to add a key. I think you need to add a key for this one as well, or set it a little bit differently for Android. I have another video on the .NET MAUI maps for iOS and Android, so I highly recommend that you check that one out if you want to get started with that one. I'm going to focus on this Windows one for now. So you have this key. And to get the key, let's hop over to our browser, which I have here. And you can go to bingmapsportal.com. Log in with your Microsoft account, and you will figure out how to do that. You will get to a screen like this one. And under my account, you can go to my keys. And under my keys, I have a couple of them already, but you can create a new one, and you can create a key for the actual thing that you're going to use here. So I'm just going to do show key here. You can see this one. Don't bother, by the time that you're watching this, this has been disabled, so don't bother typing it over from the screen. I'm just going to use this one and go back to Visual Studio. and I'm going to copy that in here. If you forget, you'll get an exception like, hey, boom, you need a Bing Maps key, right? So you can't forget because it won't work without it. Now, when we have this, the next thing that you want to do is actually use the map. Again, if you're already using the map in your project, nothing should be changed. You can just use it as is. This should be all that you need to do. But if you're going to implement the map for the first time, let's see how to do it. And this works kind of like vice versa. If you want to implement maps for iOS and Android, this should work the same way as well, because the API is the exact same. So let's go to our mainpage.xaml, and we just have the waving.net mod that we know and love. So that's in here. But you want to add the map stuff in here. So we want to do XML and S, and I'm going to call it maps. You can make that whatever you want, and search here for maps as well. And I actually think that we shouldn't do this maps.handler, but you want to have the controls.maps. It's kind of funny that it doesn't show in the IntelliSense, so make sure that you have these controls.maps. And that's it. So now we can use this maps prefix to actually reach our maps control. So let's remove all of this. I'm just going to create a maps map here, and there we have it. So we have this maps map, and here we can do all the things. I'm going to give it an X name so I can reach it from my code behind. Of course, it also has all kind of stuff for MVVM, my map. So we have this one, and let's give it a little width and height so that I know for sure that it will show up, and hide the request 500. And if I run this now, we should actually see the map in our Windows application already. So while we're waiting for that, I'm going to show you a little bit more. I'm also going to add markers and that kind of stuff. So we're going to see that. And in my code behind, it now doesn't know the counter button. So let me go to the main page code behind and remove all the code that we have right here, because this was for the new project template and I removed a bunch of XAML that it was referring to. So that's why this is happening. Removed all of that, and now we should actually see the Windows application come up this time, and we should see the map being initialized. Now, like I said, you should see a web view. It doesn't really feel like a web view, maybe a little bit, which actually loads the Bing Maps API for you. And we will do all the heavy lifting with JavaScript and that kind of stuff. So here we have the maps. The default location is Maui. Well, who would have thought? Maui, here we are, the island of Maui. You can see I can zoom by using the scroll wheel on my mouse, and I can move it around, right, by just clicking and moving the actual map. And I can zoom in somewhere else, and I can do all of this. Now, what's really cool, I think this works with hot reload, so let's let's do the XAML live preview. You know this existed, right? The XAML live preview, you can see the actual live preview of your running application. Let's pin that here, and not the diagnostic tools. So let's pin that here and zoom in a little bit so I can actually see the screen side by side here, so you can see that things are happening. And I can go over to my mainpage.xaml, and let's go over some properties here. So let's do traffic information, which is cool, right? Is traffic enabled? And let's set it to true. So now we can see all the traffic information. And actually, I need to switch over to the application because you don't see it. You can see here in the top left, slow and fast. So that is already added because we now have some traffic information. Let's go to the Netherlands and go to Amsterdam. It's always busy in Amsterdam. And you can see all this traffic information coming up, right? So this also works on iOS and Android, and now also on Windows. So we have all this traffic information. So what else do we got? We can say, is Zoom enabled? So whenever I set this to false, the Zoom is enabled by default. I can now use the scroll wheel, but nothing is happening. See, I'm doing it, but nothing is happening. While it would zoom before, I can still move it around. And if I also say, like, hey, what is the other one? Is scroll enabled, and I set that to false, then it doesn't scroll anymore. So it's more like a static map. I can now not move, and I can now not zoom. And if I set zoom to true again, or just remove it because true is the default value, now you can zoom, but you can't move it around. So you have tons of options to actually work with this map. So there is a lot of cool stuff going on here. Now, you also notice that we didn't really do any permission stuff. So if you want to do is showing the user, that's where the permission stuff comes in. I think we request the permissions, but go check it out yourself and let me know if that's not the case. If that's not the case, you have the permissions APIs, which is built into .NET MAUI, and you can request them yourself and all should be good to go. The other thing is the markers and that kind of stuff, right? So let's see, go over to our main page and let's add some markers right here. So actually, let me add a button in the XAML first. So I'm going to make this a vertical stack layout, and so that it stacks vertically. Let's add a button here with a text do things, I don't know, something like that. And then for a clicked event, I want to have this new event. Okay, so there we are. Now in our UI, you can see I got this new button do things, and I still have this map underneath it, which reinitialized because it reloaded the thing. But we have all of this. So button clicked, and now under the button clicked, I can say my map dot pins dot add, and I can add a new pin. So I can add new pin. And this is a Microsoft MAUI Controls Maps pin. So this is already there, right? So let me make this a little bit clearer so that we can just do using Microsoft.MAUI.Controls.Maps. We have that in here, and then we have this pin that we can use. And then for the pin, we have some properties, right? So let's see what we have here. We have the address. You can put the address in here. What are the important things? A label, a location, that's very important, and some other thing. A type is not, you know, really applicable to all the platforms. I think with a type, notably on Android, it will show up a little bit differently, but otherwise don't really bother with it. And so mostly the address, the label, and the location, there are the important things. So let's start with the location, and it's actually going to be a new location, which is also a built-in type for this. Actually, it's not this one. Oh, latitude, longitude. There we go. So it's a location for the map. So I don't know, let's do 50, 6, which is, you know, I know that is a coordinate on the map. I'm not really sure where it is, but that should be it. And I think you need to add a label as well. Else you will get an exception that it can be added to the map. I think that's some requirement on a platform. So let's do my, well, maybe subscribe to this channel from this location. I don't know if the label should be that long, but maybe you want to subscribe to a channel and this is your sign. Do it now. And we have the address. Let's put that in there as well. Address is my location, road 1337, something like that. So now it's going to add this new pin. And what we can then also do is say my map dot move to region, so we can move to a region. We can kind of like move the camera to this region. And here we have a map span. Now you can do a new map span, obviously, and do all these things. But map span also has a couple of extension methods, basically. So map span, I'm going to do use Microsoft MAUI Maps. It will add that here at the top, so it knows that this map span is a thing. And then I can say dot from center and radius, which is really cool. So it's going to create a map span from a center, a location that I specify, and it's going to give a radius to determine kind of like the zoom factor that it has to apply. And now I can just do new location. So let's take the same one. Of course, I should be reusing this instance, but here we are, new location. And what I'm going to do, distance. And again, distance has little helper methods. So we have distance dot, and here you can say from kilometers or between positions or from miles. So you can have these different helper methods to determine a distance that you want to show. Let's do from kilometers and let's do 10. And now we have a little new functionality that we can use here. So I'm going to save this. Actually, I don't think this is picked up by hot reload. So I changed a lot here. Let me just restart the application just to be sure that everything is working here. And now the application is going to come up. It's going to show MAUI as a initial position. You can definitely change that as well. But now when I click it, it should move me to wherever 50, 6 is. And then it's going to show me that marker, right? It's going to add that first and it's going to move it there. So here we are, subscribe to this channel from this location. Apparently it's somewhere in Luxembourg. Well, that's close-ish. So that's cool. And you can also, you know, you can have this marker. And if you click it, you will show this info window. So we will have all this. You can see the label, you can see the address right here, and you can close it again. This is all stuff that works just like all the other maps implementations. Now, you can do much more. You can add a clicked. So if I do this pin, here we are. If I create this var p is new pin, and I add the pin like this. And I also have some things that I can do with the pin, right? So I can say p.clicked. I think I have a couple of clicked events. So you can have that info window, so the little bubble and the marker. So let's do marker clicked plus is, and it generates a little method for me. And let's just do something like display alert. And I can display alert clicked, subscribe, because you still haven't done it yet. I can see it. You have to subscribe. Do it now. So okay, and we can have this alert, and the same thing works whenever we click on the info window, right? So whenever the little balloon pops up, you can also click on that balloon and you can have some action trigger that from that balloon as well. So again, that works the same way for iOS, for Android, and now also for Windows. So let's just click this button and prove it to you. If you click this marker, you will get this little alert. And that is how to implement maps also for Windows. So this is a bit of a weird video because this was already available on iOS and Android, so I'm not really telling you anything new, besides from the really cool fact that this is now also available on Windows through the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So let me know down in the comments below if you have any more questions. Find the GitHub link in the video description, and of course show me all your cool projects which you're building, which can now have Windows Maps as well. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll be seeing you for the next video.